Well, hello, students. Welcome back to an episode of Tell It Like It Was, where I, your teacher, Miss C, gives you a sneak peek into what you will be learning in history this next unit. So get excited, because here is a snapshot of the big things that happened in the United States during the 1920s and 30s. So who's ready to party? Yeah, I mean, after all, the 1920s was a grand old time for many Americans. There were new inventions, advertising everywhere, sports on the rise, and jazz tunes on the radio. I don't know about you, but I like the sound of that. And with Henry Ford's new assembly line, people were cruising the streets by the carloads. Literally. You get a Model T, and you get a Model T, and you get a Model T, and everyone gets a Model T! Oh my stars, I just had a red scare. And that's what many had in the 1920s. This fear led to the Palmer Raids, which deported many communists out of the U.S.
Girls who run the world, girls who run the world.
Remember in my last episode when I mentioned women protesting for the right to vote? Well, in the 1920s, they got it, and man, did women start to live a little more. From their head to their shoulders to their knees to their toes, hairstyles and fashion changed for all. Modernists kissed traditions goodbye.
Country, we're on!
In the 1920s, there was a period known as Prohibition, where alcohol was illegal. Did this plan work? Stay tuned to find out. And now it's time for the peak of the week. In Harlem, New York, many African Americans were making their claim to fame by playing in a jazz band. People from all over the country came to hear guys like Louis Armstrong and Duke Ellington. After the 1920s, the country entered a Great Depression, with great unemployment, great dust storms, and great homelessness. Life got pretty bad for a lot of people. Many blamed President Hoover. Some would say he was a lot like the vacuum. He sucked. But he was just more of a hands-off kind of pres. Whereas his successor, FDR, he came up with a New Deal, which was a lot more involved, and it helped much of the country get back on its feet. One more thing to say before. The Depression of the 1930s got a little better with Roosevelt in the White House, but it doesn't actually end until another horrible thing happens in our country that sends us into a second global war. Well, thanks for tuning in to this week's episode of Tell It Like It Was. Keep it real, kids, and we'll catch you next time.